Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan for the press conference of Mr. Suzuki Muneo, the leader of the new party, Daichi. So today we're going to talk about Japan-Russia relations, and that's one of the top priorities for Prime Minister Abe, who wants to solve the post-historical issues. As we all know, Japan and Russia have not signed a peace treaty, as both countries have not agreed on the attribution of northern territories or Korea Islands. But Prime Minister Abe has been shown extraordinary enthusiasm to move things forward after so many botched efforts by the Japanese government. He has frequently visited Russia, as we all know, to forge the good relations with Russian President Vladimir Putin amid international sanctions against Russia's annexation of the Crimea island. But I think it's paying the dividend, as we all know, Putin will visit Japan in December. So we are all curious about how the Prime Minister Abe and Putin will struck hikiwake or draw on this issue. And probably nobody knows better about this issue than Mr. Suzuki, as we all know. He has become an official advisor to Prime Minister, and in fact, Prime Minister visited or attended the party of his yesterday's party at Mr. Suzuki's political party yesterday. So let's hear in detail about his thoughts about this issue and what Prime Minister Abe's plan is going to be. So, Mr. Suzuki, please.
皆さん、ただいま大変丁寧な紹介をいただいたことで恐縮している鈴木宗男であります。Good
afternoon. My name is Muneo Suzuki. I'm very thankful for having this very warm introduction now.
久しぶりに外国人特派員協会に来まして、私は気が弱いもんですから、ちょっとですね、今緊張しております。
This is my first time to visit the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan for quite some time, so I'm a little bit nervous, I must say now.
私が最もこの日露関係で頼りにしたり、あるいは信頼している人に、元外務省にいたこの佐藤勝という男がおります。
There is one particular person who I place a great amount of trust and reliance on in relation to the issue of Japan-Russia relations. This is someone who used to be in the Japanese Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and Mr. Masaharu Sato.
今から25年前、この佐藤さんと出会った時、私はエストニアのタリンで佐藤さんと別れる時ですね、日露をやりたい。 まだ当時はソ連でしたけども、日ソを動かしたい。どうしたらいいかって言ったら、佐藤さんは1年に1回モスクワに来てください。私の持ってる人脈を全て鈴木先生に紹介しますと言ってくれました。
And 25 years ago, on the occasion when I met with Mr. Sato, actually this was in Tallinn in Estonia. At the time when we were saying goodbye, actually I said to him, well, I would like to make some contribution to progress between Japan-Russia relations, well, at that time the Soviet Union. And he said to me, well, then what you should do for that is come to Moscow at least once a year, and I will introduce you to all of my contacts and my network.
私は約束通り1年に1回はもちろんですけども、2回、3回、 モスクワに通って、様々な人間関係を築いてきました。And
as promised, since then I have been visiting Moscow at least once a year, in some years two or three times per year, and developing various personal relationships.
佐藤さんは10年後にはトップに会いましょう。こんな話も25年前したものです。
And at that time, in the discussions or having conversations with Mr. Sato, we said, well, 10 years later, let's meet at the top. So this is the conversation that we had 25 years ago.
10年後まさに私はロシアの大統領選挙に当選したプーチン大統領と当選後10日目にクレムリンで会談することができて森日本の総理との首脳会談の日程をセットしたものであります。
And indeed, just 10 years later, or exactly 10 years later from that meeting, I indeed had the opportunity to meet with President Putin, who on the 10th day of his election, actually, to the president of Russia at the Kremlin. So I met with him at that time and was able to set up the leaders' meeting between President Putin and Japanese Prime Minister Modi.
皆さんご案内の通り、森、プーチン、この両氏の人間関係は極めて良好で、日露関係がぐっと動いた時だと思います。
As you are aware, the relationship between these two figures, Mr. Mori and Mr. Putin, was indeed very relative. And during their time together, there was a great deal of progress in regards to relations between the two countries.
私は今でも、イルクーツク声明がこの北方領土問題解決に一番近づいた首脳会談だったと思ってます。
And I believe even today that the Irkutsk statement, which was made between these two leaders, is indeed the item which has brought us closest to resolution of the Northern Territories issue.
このイルクーツク声明の一括後に、日本では森さんから小泉総理に政権が変わりました。
And the Irkutsk statement of 2001 were following this. This was undertaken under Mr. Modi, and the government of Japan then passed over to Mr. Koizumi.
当時、田中真紀子さんが外務大臣になりですね、あの日露関係の原点は、田中ブレジネフ会談だとこう言ってですね、いわゆる冷戦時代の領土問題がないというソ連が強く出ていた時代にですね、時計の針を戻してしまいました。
At the time, Makiko Tanaka was the foreign minister of Japan, and the position stated was that the foundation or the basis between the relationship of Japan and Russia was founded on the Tanaka-Brezhnev discussions, which were, of course, at the time of the Cold War. This was at the time also when Russia was holding the position that there are no territorial disputes between the two countries. So this was actually taking us back or reversing back in time rather than having progress.
田中さんの後を継いで外務大臣になった川口依子さんは、森総理が提案したいわゆる平行協議、歯舞前四股担当を具体的に日本に返してもらう、国後択捉がどちらに帰属するか、日本、ロシアですね、この協議をしよう、いわゆる平行協議の提案、車の両輪論を言ったんですけども、これは日本の方からこの川口大臣が断ってしまいました。
And the foreign minister who followed Makiko Tanaka was Yoriko Kawaguchi. At the time, there had been a proposal by Prime Minister Modi looking for parallel discussions in regards to the four territories. So looking at, first of all, returning the islands of Habomai and Shikotan to Japan and continuing discussions in regards to the attribution or what to do with the islands of Kunashiri and Etorov. However, from the Japanese side, actually, this proposal for parallel discussions on the issue was refused by Foreign Minister Kawaguchi.
プーチン大統領は政権が変わると政府の方針も変わってしまうのかと大きな戸惑いを持つと同時に、あの当時私もこの権力闘争に巻き込まれてですね、逮捕される事態、さらには佐藤勝さんも逮捕される、また我々と同じ行動してきた東郷和彦さんも外務省からパージされるということでですね、大きなこの日露関係に空白が生じてしまいました。
And so at the time, President Putin was indeed concerned that if there were to be a change in the government or the administration in Japan, there would also be a change in regards to policy. At the same time of this, this was when there was indeed a power struggle occurring in regard, within Japan, and I myself was also embroiled within this, arrested at that time, as well as also Mr. Sato Masaru was arrested, and Tōno Kazuhiko, who was also involved in Japan-Russia relations, was purged from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. As a result, at this time of the power struggle, a blank came or arose in regards to Japan-Russia relations and progress in that respect.
あの当時、鈴木宗男は歯舞前四股担二島先行返還だとか、二島ぽっきりの主張で 国賊だとよくメディアで叩かれたものであります。
At the time in the media, I was actually often being bashed for making proposals, for example, of the advance return of only Habomai and Shikotan, or also in regards to saying, well, only those islands were attributed to Japan or belonged to Japan. And this, there was indeed media bashing in relation to my position that I was stating on these issues.
私は四島を解決するにはどうしたらいいか。入り口で止めてはいけない。出口を見据えた場合、現実的な判断をしなくてはいけない。こう考えてですね、私は動いたものであります。
However, my position was indeed looking at how to resolve the issue of these four disputed islands, these four northern territories, was that we cannot just stop at the entrance of the discussion. We cannot just put a blank there. We need to be looking forward to the exit, to where we go in regards to these discussions as well, and make realistic judgments in regards to this.
ソ連共産主義時代は四島問題がないと主張するものですから、日本は四島一括返還。その上に即時とまでつけたものです。
During the Soviet Union time, when it was indeed a communist country and the USSR position was that there was no territorial dispute, there was no issue over these four islands, this led to Japan to take the position of calling for all four islands to be returned and even going as far as to call for immediate return.
しかし、そのソ連が崩壊して自由と民主のロシアになり、エリツィン大統領になってからは四島問題がある未解決の地域である、これを話し合いで解決しよう、法と正義に基づいてですね、両国で話し合っていきましょうとなってきました。
However, following the collapse of the Soviet Union and the emergence of a free and democratic Russia, followed by President Yeltsin's coming into power as well, Russia did come to acknowledge that there was this issue, disputed issue over the four islands that was unresolved and that there would be discussions in order to go forwards on this.
日本政府もそのロシアの姿勢を評価して、この時から四島一括返還という表現はしなくなって、四島の帰属の問題を解決して平和条約、四島の帰属が認められれば島の返還時期には差があってもいいですよ、柔軟に対応しますと政府の方針を変えたものであります。
And as a result of this, the Japanese government also will praise this new position of Russia in regards to acknowledging the dispute. And indeed, Japan from that stage stopped to call for all four islands to be returned. Instead, they changed the language that they were calling to for looking at seeking resolution of the issue of attribution of the islands and working towards a peace treaty. And if attribution of the islands could be acknowledged, then Japan could also go forward in a flexible manner in regards to these negotiations.
15年前、その二島先行返還だ、あるいは二島ポッキーで終止符を打つとか、国賊扱いされた私でありますけれども、あの当時、官房副長官であったのは、今の安倍総理であります。
And so 15 years ago, at this time when there was the debate over, well, the return of two islands and whether the return of two islands would call for a resolution or a final solution for this issue and so on. At the time, the Chief Cabinet Secretary of Japan was indeed Mr. Abe.
当時の安倍副長官は記者会見等で、鈴木先生のやってきた日露関係は政府の方針であります。間違っておりませんと正しい認識を示してくれておりました。
And at the time in press conferences and so on, Mr. Abe stated that Suzuki or my position was not incorrect. It was indeed in line with the Japanese position.
私は今の安倍総理は父上であった安倍晋太郎先生の外務大臣の秘書官として、また秘書として使えられ、さらに森総理の時の官房副長官でもありますから、しっかりと頭作り、歴史の重み、あるいは積み重ねであるということをですね、正しい認識を持っておられると、私は考えており、理解しております。
And when I look at Prime Minister Abe now, of course, also considering my experience under his father, Shintaro Abe, working as a secretary in regards to foreign relations and so on, and also during the time of Prime Minister Mori, working as a deputy at that time, I believe that Prime Minister Abe does indeed have a correct or full understanding and recognition of the weight of history, the accumulated history until now.
私は今年に入ってからも6回安倍総理にお会いして必ず日露関係の話をさせていただいております。
Since entering this year, I have myself met with Prime Minister Abe on 6 occasions, and on each of these times we have discussed the Japan-Russia relations.
安倍総理は戦後71年経っても一つの島も解決していないこの現実。しかも元島民は平均年齢82歳。人生としてはそう時間は残っていない。人道的にも、そして歴史的にも、この北方領土問題、日露関係をダイナミックに動かしたいというほとばしる情熱と決意を私は会うたびに感じております。
And on my meetings with Prime Minister Abe, I can very much feel his recognition that, well, now that 71 years have passed since the end of World War II, and not even one of these islands, the issue around one, not even one of these islands has been resolved. Also, considering the fact that the average age of the former residents of the Northern Territories is now 82 years old and they do not have much time left, considering this both as a humanitarian as well as a historical issue as well, I believe that, and in my meetings, I very much feel that Prime Minister Abe has both the passion and the determination to put forward a dynamic shift in Japan-Russia relations towards resolution of this issue.
安倍総理は5月6日のソチでの首脳会談で8つの新たな政策を提示しですね、その提示した話は9月2日の首脳会談でも具体的に説明されたと聞いております。
I have heard that Prime Minister Abe on May the 6th, when he met with President Putin in Sochi, at the leaders' meeting in Sochi, put forward 8 new policies in regards to relations between the countries. Also on the meeting between the two leaders on September 2nd, Prime Minister Abe also gave a further concrete explanation of these new policies, or so I have heard.
Putin 大統領の胸にも、この安倍総理の極めて真摯な考え方、あるいは裏付けのある話は胸にきちんと入ったと思っております。
And I believe that this, well, gentlemanly proposals and way of thinking from Prime Minister Abe and very much grounded proposals being made as well have been very much received positively by Mr. Putin.
またこの5月の6日の時、プーチン大統領は9月2日、ウラジオストックでの東方経済フォーラムに安倍総理を招待する発言をしたら、安倍総理は即座に俺は行くよと答えられました。
During their meeting on the 6th of May, when President Putin made an invitation to Prime Minister Abe to attend the Far Eastern Economic Forum in Vladivostok on September 2nd, Prime Minister Abe immediately said that he would indeed attend.
これもプーチンさんには大変いい印象というか、安倍さんの人柄、これは信頼できるというふうにですね、受け止めた極めて良い判断だったと思っています。
And I believe that this left a very positive impression on President Putin, showing that Prime Minister Abe is indeed someone that he can trust, someone that he can put his trust into as well. And so I think that this was a very good judgment to have made.
私は裏上での首脳会談でですね、安倍総理は新しいアプローチという表現をされました。
During their meeting in Vladivostok between the two leaders, Prime Minister Abe used the expression of a new approach.
私は戦後71年経ってもですね、4党の主権にこだわっていればこれは進まない。打開するためにはどうしたらいいかということを安倍総理は頭に一番入れていると思います。
I believe if we look at the situation of 71 years having now passed since the end of the war, rather than focusing on the issue of sovereignty of the four islands, Prime Minister Abe is now thinking about what is needed to be done in order to resolve this issue.
プーチン大統領は一貫して1956年宣言、いわゆる平和条約締結の後には歯舞群島と色丹島を日本に引き渡すとこれ話されておられます。
President Putin has consistently said, based on the 1956 Soviet-Japanese Joint Declaration, that after a peace treaty could be concluded, then the islands of Habomai and Shikotan would be handed over to Japan.
Putin 大統領はこの56年宣言は日本の国会も批准している。当時のソ連の最高会議も批准している。今のロシアの国会に当たりますね。いわゆる法的拘束力のある義務だともはっきり言ってくれております。
And President Putin has said that this 1956 declaration, as it was ratified by the Japanese Parliament and also accepted by the highest committee within the Soviet Union at the time, which would now correspond to the Russian Federal Assembly, because it has been passed by both of these forums, it is indeed legally binding, and in fact, it is a responsibility to follow this declaration.
私はこの領土問題の解決のまず一番のスタートラインはこの1956年だと考えております。
And I believe that the starting line for resolving this territorial issue is indeed this 1956 point.
合わせて東京宣言という言葉がよく使われましたが、私は今回ソチでの首脳会談後には外務省のブリーフでも東京宣言という言葉は入ってきておりません。
And in addition to this, often there is discussion or reference made to the Tokyo Declaration. However, since the Sochi meeting, even in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs briefings, there is not actually reference being made to the Tokyo Declaration anymore.
東京宣言はご案内の通り、四島の島の名前を挙げて、どちら日本に帰属するか、ロシアに帰属するか、話し合いましょうということになっております。
As you are aware, within the Tokyo Declaration, it names the four islands and says that there will be discussion to take place about which of the islands is attributed to Japan and which to Russia.
これで議論すると、例えばロシアが4島を取ったときは日本が0です。ロシアが3のときは日本は1です。ロシアが2のときは日本が2です。ロシアが1のときは日本3です。ロシアが0のときは日本は4です。私はどちらかが100点、どちらかが0点という外交はないと思っております。
And if discussion were to take place following this stance, this standard, this would of course mean that there would be several scenarios. It could be four islands to Russia and zero to Japan, three to Russia, one to Japan, two to Russia, two to Japan, one to Russia, three to Japan, or zero to Russia and four to Japan. But I believe this kind of all or nothing, 100 or zero approach is something which is not realistic, which is not feasible within diplomacy.
安倍総理が1956年宣言をスタートラインとし、さらに日本に一番近づいたこのイルクーツク声明を変形した形での解決に向けて、私は知恵を出していく、あるいはさまざまな角度から英知を結集してですね、この12月15日のプーチン大統領の訪日までにですね、最高の判断をされるものだと信じております。
I believe that now Prime Minister Abe is using this 1956 declaration as the starting point and also the Irkutsk statement as the closest we have come to resolution of this issue. And looking at how these two agreements or these two statements and declarations can be utilized and reformed in a way to form a resolution to this issue. From now, I believe that the various wisdom and expertise and also perspectives from various angles will all be gathered together and to look towards the visit to Japan of President Putin on December 15 to see how the very best judgment can be made to make progress in this issue.
私は15日から19日まで国後島と択捉島をビザなし訪問で行ってまいりました。
From the 15th to the 19th, I visited the islands of Kunashiri and Etorov on the visa-free exchange.
Etorov は4年ぶりでしたが、4年前は1ミリの舗装道路もなかったんですが、今はナオカという中心部から空港まで全ても完全舗装になっておりました。
And the last time I had visited Etorov was 4 years ago. And at that time, there was not even 1 millimeter of fully paved roads on Etorov at the time. However, during this recent visit, we saw from the center or the main town to the airport, actually, the road was completely paved the whole way.
プーチン大統領が進める、いわゆるクリル社会発展計画は着実に予算もついて実行されているということを目の当たりにしました。
I think that this very much demonstrates that the Kuril social development plan being proposed or put in place by President Putin is indeed being implemented and has the budget allocated to it necessarily also.
私は世界一の応用技術を持っている日本が、あの北方四島に進出して、島民の生活に大きな貢献をすることによって、島民の皆さん方の受け止めも変わってくると思います。
I believe that Japan, with its highest world technology, if it were to be able to enter the Northern Territories and contribute to this development using its technology and contribute positively to the life of the island's residents as well, this would also perhaps have an impact or effect on their approach to the issue.
島民の皆さん方も日本の進出を期待しております。
The residents also have high expectations for development by Japan also.
私はこの四島での共同経済活動、一日も早く進めることがですね、この領土問題解決のまた意義になると思ってます。
I believe that implementing joint economic activities in these four islands as soon as possible, as quickly as possible, can also be an important factor in the resolution of the territorial issue.
プーチン大統領は最初の大統領を終えて2期目の当番の時ですね、自分のポケットマネーも出してストロイピンさんの銅像を作りました。
In his second term, President Putin actually used his own personal funds, his own personal pocket money, to build a statue of
Stroypin,
the former prime minister of Russia's name.
この方は帝政ロシア時代の首相で5年間やりました。
He had been the prime minister of Russia for 5 years during the imperial time.
プーチンさんはよく演説でこのストロイピンさんの演説を引用しております。
And President Putin often quotes him in his various speeches.
それはこのストロイピンが言ったことは、ロシアの力の源は極東にあり、極東に人を住まわせることがロシアの力になるという演説であります。
And this is referring to quotes saying that actually the far east region of Russia is the source for the strength of Russia, the source for Russia's power. And having people live in the far east region will itself also be the source of power for Russia.
安倍総理が2度目の政権に返り咲いた時、森元総理が安倍総理の特使として2月にプーチン大統領と会談をいたしました。
And during Prime Minister Abe's second term in February, there was a meeting between Morimoto as the representative and President Putin.
森総理は会談の前にそのストロイピンさんの銅像に献花をされました。
That was former Prime Minister Mori. And at this time, former Prime Minister Mori actually placed a flowers in at the statue.
私は森総理とプーチン大統領はとってもいい人間関係がある。そして今、安倍、プーチン両首脳の関係を極めて良好だ。そしてプーチン大統領は 80% の支持率があります。安倍総理は 50% から 60% の極めて高いまた支持を得ております。
Former Prime Minister Modi and President Putin indeed had very positive or friendly relations, and I believe that the relations between Prime Minister Abe and President Putin are also very positive. If we also look at the situation where President Putin has support ratings of around 80% and Prime Minister Abe is also enjoying support of around 50 to 60%, this is also an important point.
私は国境確定、領土問題の解決はトップの決断しかないと思っております。
I believe that for resolution or this diplomatic relations and for resolution of the territorial disputes, it will need to be a judgment coming from the top.
そういった意味で高い支持率を誇る。しかも18日の下院選挙では国会の4分の3の議席を獲得した統一ロシア、プーチン大統領の力、影響力は極めて重いものだと思っています。
Therefore, I believe that the factor that both or the leaders of both countries have such very high support rates at the moment is indeed a very major factor. Also, if we look at the results of the election which took place on the 18th and the obtaining of three quarters of the seats as well, this united Russia, shall we say, I think this shows indeed the extremely large influence and strength of President Putin at the moment.
私は12月15日に向けてその一月前の11月の19、20日には APEC でペルーのリマで首脳会談もセットされておりますので、必ず安倍総理は日本の総理として国益の観点から北方領土問題はこのラインで進めていきたい、解決したい、ぜひとも大統領ご理解いただきたいという大きな私は決断をしてくれるし、なされるものだと信じております。
And 1 month before President Putin's visit to Japan on December 15, indeed, the APEC meeting will take place in Lima, Peru. On November 19 and 20, there will also be a meeting between the leaders of the two countries. And I strongly believe, or firmly believe at that time, that President Abe will definitely, Prime Minister Abe, as Prime Minister of Japan, and with the national interests in mind, put forward that he will indeed make this significant judgment and ask for the understanding of President Putin to follow this line towards resolution of the issue.
安倍総理の提案にプーチン大統領は私は必ず答えてくれるものだと思っております。
I also believe that President Putin will indeed respond to this proposal from Prime Minister Abe.
私はプーチン大統領に対する印象は4回ほどあった中で一貫して感じていることはプーチン大統領は極めて人情家であるということです。
My impression of President Putin, having met him on 4 occasions, is very much consistent, and this is that he is indeed, well, a very human person.
私は日本の皆さん方に、特にまた国会議員の皆さん方にですね、大きな歴史の節目であります、今年は。それは1956年から60年という年でありますので、この戦後未解決の北方領土問題を両首脳の英知によって解決されるべくですね、大きな声援を安倍総理に、あるいはプーチン大統領に送っていただきたいものだと心からお願いをするものです。
And I would like to express to the people of Japan and especially to the members of the Japanese Diet that this year, 2016, we are also standing at a very important historical point. This is 60 years since 1956. Therefore, at this point, we need to look at how to work towards these unresolved post-war issues, that is the territorial disputes. And through the wisdom of both leaders of both countries, support Prime Minister Abe and President Putin towards resolution of this issue.
ご清聴ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
So, before I open it for floor, I have one question. So, you said you met with Prime Minister 6 times. So, you get the feeling that Prime Minister Abe is ready to implement the 1956 agreement by getting only 2 islands. Do you feel that way?
今この日露関係具体的に外交動いておりますのでですね、安倍総理がどう言ったか、あるいは安倍総理にはこういうラインで行きたい、あるいは考えてるんだ、受けたまわったり、あるいは私もアドバイスしたこともありますけれども、ちょっと中身についてはですね、ここは 今大事な時期ですのでですね、あの安倍総理の足を引っ張るようなあの中身の話はですね、避けらせていただきたいと思います。
In regards to relationship between Japan and Russia, because of course this is an ongoing concrete diplomatic issue with negotiations underway at the moment. Of course, in my discussions with Prime Minister Abe, he has shared various information with me and I have also provided advice. However, in regards to specifically what he has said, what line he will be going down, what his thoughts are on this issue, because we are indeed now at such crucial timing, in order not to obstruct the efforts that Prime Minister Abe is now trying to implement, I will refrain from making specific comments about his plans.
ただ一つ言えることはですね、間違いなく安倍総理は日露関係を良い方向に未来志向で動かしたいという強い決意と覚悟を持っておられるということは事実だと私は信じております。
However, the one comment which I will make is that I believe that Prime Minister Abe is definitely making efforts in a forward-thinking way to make concrete progress in relations between Japan and Russia. And he has the determination and preparedness to actually implement this.
Okay, now let's open to the floor. So the gentleman there first and then second. Please address your affiliation and name.
フリーランスの小林と申します。力強い、説明をありがとうございました。日本の基本的な領土問題に対する姿勢、その根本的な考え方について伺います。日本の戦後のですね、ロシアに対する領土解決の方法として、日本は政経不可分、ロシアは経済的に苦しい立場にあるから、日本が経済的な協力をすればロシアは譲歩してくるという思想で今までやってきました。Please.
My name is Kobayashi. I am a freelancer. I would like to ask a question regarding Japan's basic stance on the territorial disputes. In regards to Japan's methods or stance for resolution of this issue in the post-war era, it has very much taken the position that Russia is in a position of struggling economically. Therefore, Japan would provide economic cooperation and hope that this would bring Russia on board.
鈴木先生もそのために大変な努力をされて、大変な被害にも遭われました。しかしそれを振り返ってみますと、その結果何も変わっていないと、領土問題は解決していない。そして今日の日本安倍政権がやろうとしているその発想の中には、その昔の政経不可分の考え方と全く同じ考え方が支配しているように私には思えます。
And Mr. Suzuki, you yourself have indeed put forward various efforts for this, and you have also been victimized somewhat as a result of your efforts as well. However, if we reflect back, I think it can be said that there has been no change or no resolution of the territorial disputes as a result of this. If I look at Prime Minister Abe's stance now, I believe that there is actually still remaining very much the common or the very same stance as he had before.
過去に効果がなかったその反省を踏まえてですね、新しい発想の中には何か新しい酒が入っているんでしょうか、スピリットが。
And therefore, I would like to ask, as this has indeed shown no results in the past, if there is reflection upon this, and if new efforts or new parts are being introduced into the approach of Prime Minister Abe now.
はい、小林さん、ご質問ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much for your question, Mr. Kobayashi.
小林さん、お分かりかと思いますけども、政経不可分というのは、ソ連時代に使った言葉であります。
And as I believe you are aware, the term which you were referring to is indeed one which was used during the Soviet era.
ソ連末期のゴルバチョフ大統領が誕生してからは、拡大均衡という方針に日本政府は改めました。
And actually, since the later part of the Soviet era, since around the Gorbachev days, indeed this has changed, and Japan looking at or being positioned in a way as a very large, well, safe or a bank, shall we say.
さらに自由と民主のロシアになってからは、四島の帰属の問題を解決して平和条約ということで、日本はソ連が崩壊した後、人道支援等ですね、手厚く北方領土にですね、行ったということをですね、 ここはしっかりご理解をいただきたいなとこう思っております。
However, if we look at the following years and the emergence of the free and democratic Russia and the change in the stance of Japan or the expression of Japan of looking at the attribution of the four islands and working towards a peace treaty, Japan has implemented a great deal of humanitarian assistance to the northern territories as well. And this is one point which I would like to draw your attention to.
その新しい発想に何かそのスピリットが入っているのかどうかという話でありますけれども、私は安倍総理には考え方がある。それはロシアも良かった、日本も良かったというですね、この気持ちを大事にしながら、日本が100点、あるいはロシアが0点、逆にロシアが100点、日本が0点、これでは先に進まない。71年前と同じ状況で動かない。これから70年ももう待てないというですね、現実的な判断をお持ちだと私はこう受け止めております。
And as to whether there are remnants of this old spirit or stance within the new approach of Prime Minister Abe, I believe that Mr. Abe has indeed his own way of thinking, his own way of looking at this issue, and is valuing looking at a way which can be positive for both Russia and Japan, rather than looking at, well, 100 and 0, or all or nothing for one of the countries or vice versa. He recognizes that if this were to be pursued, we would not have any progress. This would be the same situation as 71 years ago, and we cannot wait another 71 years for resolution of this issue. Therefore, I believe strongly that Prime Minister Abe is indeed making a realistic judgment towards resolution.
Süddeutsche Zeitung Neidhardt. In 1956, it was Japan who walked away first from the joint declaration, and the reason was pressure from the US. What gives you the confidence that even if Abe reaches an agreement, that there is no pressure from the US again, since the White House and especially the Pentagon already have pressured Abe not to approach Putin at this time? Thanks.
はい、ご質問ありがとうございます。
Thank you for your question.
今お話しあった通り、1956年当時の鳩山一郎総理は2党でも署名しようかという動き、流れもありました。
As you mentioned, at the time of 1956, under Prime Minister Ichiro Hatoyama, there was even a discussion of accepting two islands return, for example.
しかし、あの年、1956年の8月、当時のアメリカのダレス国務長官は、日本の重光外務大臣に、ロンドンにおいて、ソ連と平和条約を結ぶならば、沖縄は返さない。未来永劫アメリカの施政権下に置くというですね、話がありました。いわゆるダレスの恫喝であります。
However, in August of 1956, the then Secretary of State of the United States, Mr. Dulles, said to Foreign Minister Shigemitsu of Japan that if Japan were to pursue or to conclude a peace treaty with Russia, then the United States would not return Okinawa to Japan. And this was indeed the pressure that was put by the United States at that time.
私は日米同盟というのは日本外交の一つの大きな基軸でありますからですね、これは避けて取れないんですけども、今年2月安倍総理とオバマ大統領との電話会談でも、アメリカ側はロシアに行くな、あるいはプーチンを呼ぶなという話がありましたけども、安倍総理は毅然と日本には北方領土問題がある、アメリカとは立場が違う、はっきり申し上げて、オバマさんもですね、理解をされた。その結果として5月の伊勢志摩サミットにも来られ、広島も訪問された。これからもアメリカのさまざまな分野からの声があると思いますけれども、安倍総理は十分それに応えていくというのは、日本の姿勢をですね、しっかり理解される端力、政治家としての腹積もりを持っていると、こう私は受け止めております。
And of course, I believe that the alliance between the United States and Japan is very much one of the strong pillars of Japan, something which cannot be gone around. However, if we look, for example, even of the situation of in February this year at the telephone meeting between Prime Minister Abe and President Obama, at that time from the United States side, there was a request for Japan or the Japanese leader not to go to Russia or to likewise invite the Russian leader to come to Japan. However, Prime Minister Abe clearly stated in response to this that Japan is in a different position than the United States. It has this territorial dispute with Russia. Therefore, it will go forward with this. And President Obama indeed did express understanding in regards to this difference of point stated by Prime Minister Abe. As a result, following this in May, of course, President Obama did attend the Iseshima Summit and also visited Hiroshima. So I believe that there will be, of course, various voices or concerns being expressed from different fields or different parts within the United States from now also. But I believe that Prime Minister Abe very much has the strength as a politician to respond to this and to seek understanding of the Japanese stance.
Mr. Jimbo, please.
ビデオニュースの神保です。日本語で質問します。今の話はちょっとまだしにくいこともあるということで、昔の話をぜひ伺いたいんですけど、先ほど鈴木先生とそれから東郷さんや佐藤さんがね、二党先行返還論って言い方が正しいかどうかともして、そういう主張をしたためにですね、パージされたと、逮捕までされたというお話をされた。ぜひお伺いしたいのは、パージしたのは誰で、何のためにパージする必要があったのか、そして今もそれに近いような話で進んでいるように見受けられますが、とすると何か状況が変わって、当時パージされて逮捕されるようなことだったことが今はありになったんだとすれば、それは何が変わったのか、その点をお願いします。
My name is Jimbo from Video News. You mentioned that it's difficult to talk about the current issues, so I would like to ask about something from several years ago. You mentioned that because of your position in regards to, well, shall we say, the advance return of two islands and so on, yourself, Mr. Sato and Mr. Togansson, were purged and even arrested as a result of this. I would like to ask who you believe was behind this purging, for what reasons it was seen to be necessary, and also indeed whether there are similar circumstances at the moment, or if there are in fact has been a change in the conditions or a change in the circumstances now, so that a position which then would result in this purging is now something which is seen as, well, acceptable.
15年前、小泉政権が誕生して、小泉さんは新自由主義の考え、政策でした。
15 years ago, at the time of the birth of the Koizumi administration, this was also the time of the neoliberal politics or policies and stance at the time.
強い者が善で弱い者は悪というような、この格差の広がる、いわゆるハイエク型の政治は、私は日本には合わないと主張しました。
And under this neoliberal system, looking at, well, those who are strong are good, can go forward, and those who are weak can be left behind, and so on. Something which also led to further disparity or gaps within society as well. I vocally took the stance that this kind of politics is not suitable, is not good for Japan.
私はこのエネルギー資源なき国家日本、しかも狭いこの国土等を考えたとき、ケインズ型の公平配分が日本に合ってるんだと主張したら、抵抗勢力と言われまして、メディアからも、あるいは世論からもですね、人気のある小泉総理、あるいは田中真紀子外相でありましたからですね、私は一心にその悪い方のこの代表になってしまいました。
And considering Japan's position as a country which lacks its own energy and natural resources and so on, and which also has very small territory, the policies I was putting forward, which I believe that Japan should have been following, were seen as, well, being a force of resistance against that new Koizumi administration and so on. This was also being raised in such a way within the media and also within the public opinion. And so in respect to the very popular at the time Prime Minister Koizumi and followed by Foreign Minister Makiko Tanaka as well, I was held up as sort of the representative opposition force or the representative resistance force against that.
あれから14年経って私は落ち着いた雰囲気になって、で今の日本の現状を見るときに地方再生だとかという、やはり地方を大事にするなという声が出てきたりしておりまして、まともな議論ができる環境になってきたと思っております。
And I believe that 14, now that 14 years have passed, the discourse within Japan is finally acknowledging the need to look at the importance of the rural parts of Japan, or the decentralization and so on as well. It has settled in such a way so that the Japanese situation has caught up with this. We see, for example, the government putting forward terms such as, well, the revival of the rural parts of Japan and so on. So I believe that now a, well, clear or more calm discussion about this is finally taking place now in Japan 14 years later.
その状況で安倍総理も未来志向で現実的な判断で、この喉に刺さったトゲのような状況とも言ってもいい、この北方領土問題を解決してロシアと平和条約を結ぶのが日本の国益に資するというお考えを持っていると思っております。
Therefore, I believe that now we are in this situation where Prime Minister Abe, indeed with a future-oriented and realistic judgment approach to the situation, despite being a very, very difficult situation about the territorial disputes, is now also seeing that resolution of these disputes and conclusion of a peace treaty with Russia is indeed in the national interests of Japan also.
私は今の、あの、安倍総理の考えや行動を全面的に支持するし、また私の経験だとか今までの培ってきたものをすべてですね、安倍総理に私なりの立場でお話をしていきたい、まあ、してきたし、これからもしていきたいと思っております。
Therefore, I completely and fully support both the way of thinking and also the actions of Prime Minister Abe now in relation to this. I hope to, and I have until now and will continue to utilize my expertise, my experience over the years in regards to this issue, to share this with Prime Minister Abe as I can in a way to contribute to this until now and from now also.
Gentlemen there.
Siegfried Nidl, writing for the Austrian newspaper Der Standard. I think the Ochotsk Sea is of a strategic importance for Russia, and the Kuril Island, the western border of this Ochotsk Sea. So, in time of increasing tension between U.S. and Russia, do you think Russia will?Give up some of the islands of the Kuril Islands to give up this advantage and to have this close Ochotsk Sea as a strategic sea.
あの今のご質問もですね、よくあの出てくる話です。
Thank you. The question you have posed is indeed a point which often comes up.
私は北海道でそのオホーツク海側、あるいはその、根室側も、まあ、選挙区、昔の選挙区でもあったし、今も選挙区なんでありますけども、一番あの場所を知ってるものとしてですね、冷戦時代と今の時代では全くあのオホーツク海域、あるいは島の防衛的な安全保障上のですね、価値は変わってきたと思っております。
And the area of Hokkaido, and indeed this side located on the Sea of Ochotsk around Nemuro is indeed my own electorate as well. So I know the region and the area there very well. And I would like to say that actually the value or the worth of this area from a security and defense perspective is completely different now than it was to during the Cold War time, both in regards to the sea and also the islands.
私はそういった意味でですね、まあ、戦略的な重要性という観点よりも、私はこれからは北極海航路だとか、あの経済的な面でのですね、ロシアも使える、もちろん日本も使える、これまたアメリカも使えるというような
And I believe that this region, its strategic importance is shifting from what had been from a more defense or security related aspect very much more to an economic importance now as well for the use of Russia and Japan and indeed also for the United States.
すると私は今自由と民主のロシアになりですね、ウクライナ問題でアメリカと緊張感があると言ってもですね、かつてのキューバ危機のような状況ではないわけでありますのでですね、ここはこれからの時代は私は国対国というよりも見えざる敵、テロとの戦いだという方がですね、世界の主要国にとっても喫緊の課題だとこう思っておりますので、あのオホーツク海域あるいは北方四島周辺におけるですね、私はこの安全保障上のあの価値というのはそう心配しなくてはいいんでないかという私は楽観論であります。
And when we consider the situation, well, under the current free and democratic Russia, well, of course, there are increasing tensions with the United States surrounding the issue of Ukraine. This is not like the situation which was seen, for example, at the time of the Cuban crisis. In the era now, rather than state-to-state tensions, state-to-state situations, the largest threat is indeed the invisible threats being faced in a common way, such as terrorism. Therefore, with this in respect, I am perhaps somewhat optimistic, and I think that the security value of the Sea of Okhotsk and the disputed islands is not something to be so concerned about now.
Mr. Suzuki has agreed to stay on another 10 minutes, so, okay, Isabel, and then you, and then... And
Isabel Reynolds from Bloomberg. You mentioned that the surviving former residents of the islands are now, the average age is 82. After having been away from the island so long, how many of them do you think still want to go back? Do you see there being a big Japanese population on the islands in future?
はい。元島民の人とも私は一番接触している政治家だと熟しておりますが、元島民の多くは自由に生きたい、いわゆる自分のふるさとですね、あるいは先祖の墓がありますから自由にまたお参りしたいというのが最優先で、また戻って住むという人は少ない、もう極めて少ないというのが、あの元島民の皆さん方との意見交換の中でですね、私が受け止めている認識です。
I believe that I am probably the politician who has the most contact and communication with former residents of the Northern Territories. And within my discussions with them, I think that the highest priority expressed by most of the former residents is their strong wish to be able to go freely to their hometowns, to freely travel back and forth. And of course, because the graves of their ancestors are also located on the islands, they want to be able to freely go to visit their ancestors' graves. However, the number of former residents who express a desire to actually return there to live, I believe, is very few.
Okay, so the gentleman there, there, and there, please keep the question really short.
時事通信の記者で松尾と申します。あの私もちょっと昔のことをお尋ねさせていただきたいんですが、20年ほど前私沖縄にいまして、あの沖縄の基地負担をですね、本土が引き受けるっていうことを実現させたのは先生だけなんですね。沖縄県民が暮らしている、普通に暮らしている県道越えに、その県道を越えてですね、実弾砲撃演習をやってるのを、まあ、本土に持っていくっていうことを、やったのが、まあ、先生だけで、あれから20年経ってそれをやれた日本の政治家一人もいないんですね。誰一人として引き受けてあげるってことをしなくて今こうなってると。あの時のあの突破力があればですね、もしあのイルクーツク宣言の後ああいうことにならなければ、車の両輪というのはどういうふうにして突破していこうというふうに考えていらしたんでしょうか。あの必ずこれからもそうだと思いますが、抵抗あると思います。あの先ほどの2党返還先行論もそうですけれども、3党だってあの多分そうなるでしょう。一体どういう抵抗があって、どういうふうに解決していこうというそのビジョンとか映像を描いてたんでしょうか。この15年間もしこういうことになっていなければ、何があってどういうふうにしていこうというふうなあの 考え方だったんでしょうか。そこをお聞かせ願えればと思います。
My name is Matsuo from Jiji. I would like to also ask a question in regard to the past. I was also based in Okinawa and looking at the issue of the shifting of the burden of the US bases in Okinawa to the mainland as well. I believe that Mr. Suzuki, you were one of the politicians really who very much took that on and took the leadership to take progress in that issue. However, this has not been seen by other politicians since then, which is why we also are facing the current situation we have in Okinawa today. I would like to ask if we look back to the time of the Irkutsk statement in 2001. In the time since then, I would like to ask how you thought that we could go forward in this, your vision, for example, of what should be done in order to this. And of course, there was resistance at the time, for example, in regards to the proposal of the advanced return of two islands, or I think even if it was discussion of three islands, there would even be resistance now. I would like to ask what steps or what vision you had at this time 15 years ago in order to make progress in this.
Matsuo-san, ありがとうございます。私はこの沖縄のことも一生懸命やった。これは皆さんにも一つ分かってほしいのは、先の大戦で沖縄では20万の人が亡くなっております。そのうち16万人が沖縄県の軍人軍属民間人です。次に犠牲が多いのは北海道人の1万1000人であります。あとは東京福岡の2000から3000人だとか、あとは1000人だとかというですね、数なんです。北海道の人が一番犠牲になっている。その上での今日の平和であるということを私は考えてですね、沖縄問題を取り組んできたということをお分かりよくお気をいただきたいと思います。
Thank you very much for your question. As you mentioned, I have also dedicated myself over many years to working on the issues faced by Okinawa. I would like to express that during World War II, the number of casualties or deaths in Okinawa reached 200,000 people, and of this, 160,000 were indeed civilians as well. The prefecture which had the next highest number of casualties was indeed Hokkaido, actually, with 110,000. Following this were places such as Tokyo and Fukuoka, who had perhaps 2,000 to 3,000 people or civilians losing their lives at the time. However, I think that the fact that Hokkaido also, people suffered so much during that war, their sacrifice, and that the current peace we have today is based on this is something which I would like to draw your attention to. And this is indeed one of the reasons why I have also worked so hard on the Okinawan issue over these years also.
今いつも新聞の記事になってる辺野古問題ですけども、名護に移設を決めたのは当時の比嘉という市長さんの決断で、私はこの比嘉さんという市長とも何十年という付き合いの中でですね、受けてもらったものであります。
And the issue of the construction of the new base at Henoko is in the news very often today. The decision made to relocate this base to the city of Nago was made under the then Mayor Higa. And actually, I have known him for many, many decades. And it was a result of this. Actually, the city of Nago accepted this relocation of the base.
この問題が解決しないのも私は政治がなかったと思ってるし、やはり全てが積み重ねですから、過去の歴史だとか、何があったかということをしっかり認識しないこの人たちが出てきたことによって混乱を招いたと思っております。
And I believe that the reason that this issue has not yet reached resolution, well, partly the political steps towards this were not in place as well. But of course, this all builds up and accumulates together to make a resolution. Therefore, I believe that a full recognition of the history of what happened and what is in the background of this, the fact that this recognition was not sufficient, I believe, is what has led to the confusion leading to this situation not yet being resolved.
そこで北方四島について私が考えた、あるいは佐藤さんなり東郷さんとも考えたのは、四島を解決するにはどうしたらいいかということを考えたときにですね、四島を返してくれと言ったら、もう言った段階で交渉にはならない、話が止まってしまうんですね。
And so if we go to the discussion of the Northern Territories and what well, I myself or also colleagues such as Sato Otogo were pushing forward, well, when we think about how to resolve the issue of the four islands, of course, if we go from the starting point of requesting all islands to be returned, then this would not even open up negotiations. Everything would completely stop there.
私は先ほども言ったように政府の方針通り動いてきました。
As I mentioned, I have been moving according to the Japanese government's policies.
外務省が ソ連時代の四島一括が国是だという方針を自由と民主のロシアになってからいわゆる1991年以降四島一括返還でなくて四島の帰属の問題を解決してですよという説明を国民にしっかりしておけば私が国賊扱いされることはなかったと思っております。
And I believe if we look at, well, under the, or during the Soviet era, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs was talking about, well, the return or the immediate return of all four islands. However, under the change to a the free and democratic Russia, and indeed particularly in the post-1991 era, the fact that this explanation changed from calling for the return of all four islands specifically in that way to looking towards resolving the issue of attribution of the islands. I believe that if the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and so on had fully explained this to the people of Japan, then I would not have been treated as such a well traitor or in this way as well.
2000年9月にプーチン大統領は国連総会に行く時ですね、わざわざ日本に寄ってからニューヨークに向かわれました。
In September of 2000, President Putin, on his way to the United Nations General Assembly, made a deliberate stop to call by Japan on his way to New York.
あの時プーチン大統領とサシで東京で会談したのは森総理はもちろんですが、橋本元総理が表敬でお会いしました。
And at that time, of course, Prime Minister Modi had a meeting one-on-one with President Putin in Tokyo. But at the time, also former Prime Minister Hashimoto did also have a meeting.
私もサシで会談する機会を得ました。それは4月に大統領選挙に当選して間もないプーチンさんと会った縁でですね、ロシア側から鈴木宗男とも会いたいということでですね、会談できたんです。
And I myself also had the opportunity to meet one-on-one with President Putin. This was following his election to president in April. From then, actually, the Russian side had asked to have a meeting with me or had raised my name for a meeting, indeed.
これにはちょっと背景がありまして、私はこの4月4日に会談、プーチンさんと会談したとき、大統領から一つ頼まれたのは、アルクシー二世、ロシア正教の総主教が、日本に6月行かれる。その際、天皇陛下にぜひともお会いしたいというですね、メッセージを受けて回り、それを森総理と相談してですね、宮内庁の方もですね、時間的な協議の時間も十分あるもんですから、その中でですね、実現できました。このこともロシア正教を大事にするプーチンさんは非常にですね、関心を持ってくれたところを持っております。
And I believe there was also a further background to this meeting. During my previous meeting in April with President Putin, he had made a request to me, and he had said actually that a leader of the Russian Orthodox Church would be visiting Japan in June, and he asked for a meeting with the Emperor to be organized during the time of this June meeting. I consulted with Prime Minister Modi and with the necessary officials and so on as well, and we were able to realize this meeting in June as well. And because President Putin does, of course, value the Orthodox Church in this way as well, I believe that this was also in the background to why he requested or why the Russian side requested this meeting with me.
その2000年9月の会談の際、我々はいわゆる56年宣言を文書で認めていただきたいというお願いをしました。
And during this meeting in September of 2000, we made a request for the 1956 Joint Declaration to be fully recognized as a text.
しかし大統領はまだ就任して半年だと、日本以外にも領土問題の話が出てくる、あるいはあるやもしれない。今回は記者会見で56年宣言の有効性は認めるから、次の首脳会談では文書にしたいのでという話がありまして、それを了といたしました。
However, at this time, President Putin had only been in position for around 6 months. And because of the fact that there could be also potential or territorial disputes with countries other than Japan, he said, well, in this time, we will not put it in writing. However, in the press conference, I will directly acknowledge the validity of the joint declaration. And then on the next meeting, on the next occasion, we will put this in writing. And we accepted this.
翌年の3月25日、イルクーツク声明にですね、プーチンさんは約束通り56年宣言の有効性をですね署名書いていただき、その後もプーチンさんはこの56年宣言の有効性は絶えず発言されているということであります。
And following this, or in the next year, on March the 15th, this was at the time of the Irkutsk statement. And at this time, as promised, President Putin did in writing acknowledge the validity of the 1956 declaration and signed off on this as well. And he has upheld this in the years since then and continued to refer to or make statements in regards to this.
これからしても私はプーチンさんは約束を守る人だしですね、安倍総理がやはり現実的な解決論という頭作りをする上でも、この1956年宣言をもとにですね、そしてそのイルクーツク声明を生かしながらですね、問題解決に向かっていく、当時もですね、その流れであったということをですね、私は今、安倍総理の動きを見ているときにですね、やはり解決のためにはお互いの理解が必要だ、あるいはお互い良かったという方向でなければいけないという私は考えに基づいて今さまざまな発言をされているとこう思っております。
And since this time, I believe that President Putin is a man who keeps his promises. And as Prime Minister Abe is also working towards this realistic resolution with the 1956 declaration as the basis, but also looking at utilizing the Irkutsk statement, I believe that, well, then and now my stance is consistent in that working or using these two as the basis to work towards resolution of this. I think that when we look at the recent movements of Prime Minister Abe in relation to this as well, we can see very much that he has the recognition that to resolve this issue, what is required is mutual understanding and also a resolution which will be positive for both countries. And so this is, well, my view or my vision at that time and also still today.
So we can have last question. So gentlemen over there, please keep your question very short.
週刊現代の近藤と申します。今日はありがとうございます。ちょっと中国について聞きたい、お伺いしたいんですが、安倍政権のですね、この4年近い外交を見てますと、中国への対抗という意識がすごく強いように見受けられます。それで今回の、ロシアとのですね、北方領土問題の解決および平和条約の締結ということになりますと、これはその安倍政権がやっている中国への対抗という意味でどのような意義もしくは意味を持つことになるんでしょうか。ご見解をお聞かせください。
I am from 週刊現代. I would like to ask a question in regards to China. If we look at Prime Minister Abe's diplomacy over the past 4 years, we can see that, well, resistance or going up against China is indeed one major factor within this as well. I would like to ask if we are looking towards a resolution of the Northern Territories issue or conclusion of a peace treaty with Russia, what kind of significance this has in regards to this relationship with China or this, well, resistance within the diplomacy in relation to China?
私は安倍総理が中国への対抗でですね、ロシアと向き合っているとは考えておりませんし、受け止めておりません。
I personally do not think that Prime Minister Abe is looking towards Russia or working with Russia as a way to go against or resist China. I don't believe that that is the situation.
安倍総理はロシアも中国も韓国も隣国です。この隣国とはお互い折り合いをつけながら仲良くやっていかなくてはいけないという考えであります。
I believe that Prime Minister Abe views Russia, China, and also the Republic of Korea, all of course, as neighboring countries who need to be able to work together and build a positive relationship.
我々個人的に隣にちょっと変わった人が引っ越してきた。こんなものと付き合いたくないと思えば引っ越しもできるし、普段口を交わす必要もないんです。
Of course, on a personal level, for example, if somebody a little bit strange moved into the house next door to you, you could make the choice to move away, or you could make the choice to, well, not talk to them.
国と国は引っ越しできません。隣国はここは折り合っていくしかないんですよね。
But of course, on the country level, it is impossible for a country to move away from a neighbor. Therefore, it is necessary for countries to be able to find a way to work together.
安倍総理はそういった意味では広い心を持って対中、対韓、そして対ロ関係を外交を行っていると私は認識しておりし、それを実行していると。
Therefore, I view Prime Minister Abe at the moment as having quite a well, generous approach and looking towards developing diplomacy and relations with the neighbors of China, Korea, and Russia as well. I believe that he is also implementing this.
So that will wrap up our press conference today. Thank you very much, Mr. Suzuki, for sharing us insightful thoughts. We're looking forward to the outcome of the December 15th meeting between Prime Minister Abe and Putin. Here's the
one honorary membership. Thank you.